Hi, Pudge and I are here to welcome a new puppet to our menagerie. Right, Pudge? Her name is Amelia. Uh-oh, join us. Hi, this is Tweek. We're coming up on that favorite time of year when you do your favorite things. And one of the things that I love to do is make puppets. When I make a puppet, I'm never sure exactly how it's going to turn out. And the fabric that I find around me usually dictates what kind of creature it ends up being. So let's see, what fabric did I find? I found an old hat, and it had lots of fuzzy fur around it. So I deconstructed the hat. And I thought, oh boy, this looks to me like a cat. So yes, gonna make a cat. And here we go. A sock puppet always starts with a sock. So I have a black sock. And I have a glue gun ready. And I have fabric about me. So let's see how this is gonna fashion out. I always punch in the toe, and that creates an area for the mouth. And that's just a basic start. My hand fits up inside the heel, and that becomes a natural forehead area. What I'm gonna do today is actually flip this out, cut off some of that inner sock because there's too much. And if I mess this up, I've got extra socks. And now I'm just gonna very quickly glue this end closed again. Working with sock puppets, I get burned a lot with the glue, but just try to be careful when I do this. I'm gonna edge those two pieces together. So I've closed off the excess fabric in the toe and put my hand back in there, flip it back around. There we go. So now when I come back through, I can push this in like I wanted to, and there's less inside. There's more room for my hand to maneuver. Got the head. Got a little bit of a gray, because if this is going to be a cat, I want a little bit of color on his nose. Next, I'm going to fashion the fabric that I have here. Play around and see how it sits. And to me, I like, let's see if we try it the other way, just take the pieces I've got. Oh, I kind of like that too. Okay, I'm going to run with the way I had it first. So I'm going to lay down some glue, and very gently, because my hand is in there, add the glue to the sock. Let's see, is that how I want you to look? Yeah, okay, that's what we're gonna do. Lay it up on the side here and try to position it where I want. This is good. I feel some warmth, but there's nothing burning. And then once I get it set in place, I'm going to throw some on the back here. We're going to have our kitty head in just a minute. And I'm just laying it over the sock. Okay, next. I want to take my hand out. Mission accomplished. We have a head. I want to attach a little more just in this area here. Coming along. We've got a head. We've got to add the rest of you, though. I'm going to take this piece of an old scarf, and I'm going to pull the sock through it because my hand is going to be up in there. So I'm going to attach the sock to this fabric, and that's strictly for color. So what I'm going to do right here is just attach this old scarf material to the sock and the fur in the back here. And here we go. I'm just making sure that these two materials are sticking together. Now let's play around with the bigger body part. This is the rest of that hat. This part in here was where the ears of the hat were, and this part just went around the whole edge of the hat. So this is going to be his spine. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna attach this up first. Get the two ends, get them to squish together a little bit. Once I have that secured, I can use the fur itself to help hide the seam. He's gonna be a little more scruffy, but that's okay. Kitty, you're coming along. I'm gonna take this fur and I'm gonna attach it right up next to his head fur. And I'm gonna very carefully start running glue along that outer sock. I'm gonna go a little at a time so I can glue it and mess with the fur a little bit so it sticks. I'm just gonna work my way around. So here we go, a little at a time. The fur is helping a lot to protect my fingers from that glue. This keeps the sock inside all protected too, so hand goes easily in and out of the puppet. If they are coming apart, now is the time to glue them up. So make sure that black socky part fabric is attached. Again, an old hat. I use old hats, old scarves. I'm just going to add a little bit of fur to right under his neck. And it's going to make a random cut. Let's see. I want the fur to go in a certain direction, so be mindful of the fabric, how it's laying. No measuring. We're just going to what it looks like. I'm just going to lay this in. Try to save as much of the fur around it as I can so it sticks out all over. Okay. It's part of the fun. You never know how they're going to turn out until they're done. At least I think that part's fun. Socks still safely inside. That's our base, and I'm gonna make two fuzzy, furry legs that matches this fur, determining how long I want the legs to be. Just about 6-7 inches. Okay, there's gonna be fur everywhere, but that's what we expect. Okay, I'm going to cut it in half. Pull it off a little bit, then I'm going to roll this up. I might have to take a little more off, but that ends up being a leg. Yeah, a paw. I'm just gonna fold it in itself. They end up with really furry feet. I'm gonna round this off just a little bit in the bottom. All right, so I've got two little pockets here. I'm gonna attach the paws to the orange part of the fur. So I'm just pressing that fur for the leg in on the back side of the orange. And we have a paw. Look at that. That looks good. Okay, I'm gonna put them on again for reference. Go inside this outer sleeve that hides my arm. Go into the sock, which is still in there. Push my way up into his head. So I've got my hand up inside the sock, and I've got it positioned now. I can maneuver the mouth around. So now I want to secure that a little bit. I want to add eyes, a nose, a tongue. The first thing I'm going to do is pull in a little bit of glue on each side of the cat's mouth. That'll help hold that sock in place. So when I pull my hand in and out, it's not going to alter the looks of the kitty. So with my hand in there, I'm going to put just a little dot of glue on one side. And just hold it. And I'll do the same on this other side here. Now I can pull my hand out and the sock will stay in place, which is what I wanted. Good. Now I can work on his face. And I'm thinking of this little piece of fabric here that would make a really cute tongue. A little tiny, tiny tongue in his mouth. Yeah, I like that. So I'm gonna just take this piece of fabric that was kicking around. Oh, he's starting to get some character now. Yeah, I think that's good. Meow. Just gluing that right to the sock. So my hand will be in there. Got a tongue. Now I want to make a nose, a little tiny nose. Himalayans have the tiniest little nose. Put his nose right there and I'm going to pinch it. Where'd your nose go? This fabric is kind of neat because it has a shiny side to it. Oh, just lost it. Nose. His nose is set. His tongue's in there. Where to put his eyeballs. I think before I decide that, I'm going to add some ears. Okay, so we got little teeny ears. So I'm just going to double this over. So I reproduce the ears the same, and they've got little round ears, tiniest little ears. where are they gonna show in all your fur? But that's how the kitties are. I like it, so I'm gonna put one here. I'm really gonna just let the glue and the fur hold that ear in place. Okay, come right in here. I lost your ear, where'd it go? Okay, there it is. We have our ears. Eyes, I have two little teeny googly eyes. Because these kitties have little eyes. He looks a little too friendly though. Because to me, Himalayan cats were a little more on the grumpy looking side. That's better. If I hide his eyes in the fur a little bit, he looks a little grumpier. I'm actually gonna put his eye up like that. Here we go, eyeballs. Pile of glue. Set the eye how I want. I think I have it set. I'm letting the fur just come in around it. I'm gonna take a little teeny bit of all its fur that's kicking around. I'm just going to, this is just a whim. I'm gonna add some in like eyebrows or something. Let me find here some. Oh gosh, you're gonna get meaner. I'm just gonna put a little bit of glue on this instead of putting it on him. Okay, he's become a little grumpier. That's good. So I've been working with this black fur on his face. I'm just adding bits until I got the look I wanted. See? He's getting a little better here. Might add another little piece over here. So I'm just expanding his face a little bit and making it a little wider and flatter. Just using just chunks of this fur. And you're just working with it until it looks how I think I want it to look. I think he needs a little more hanging down here. Lots of little ragged pieces. Ooh, this one's good. Okay, see? Now this is looking better. The eyes are good. The ears are sticking out. And you know what? I covered up his nose in the black fur, so I'm going to go ahead and give him another nose. His little tongue is still in there. So let's get a little piece of that fabric that I liked. Cut you out another nose. A little bit too angular at the top, I went around. There we go. This is it, kitty. This is your nose. Let me see. Okay, there's your nose. I'm gonna put some fur around you. You got a weird nose. I'm gonna cut it down just a little more. Okay. A tiny bit of glue. I feel like I'm gonna get burned on this one. I'm gonna put it right in here. Right over your mouth. And I'd say, good. I've got to do a tail. Oh my goodness, you are crazy looking. Okay, tail. You need a nice fluffy tail. Big Himalayan kitty like you. Again, coming back to the black fur. And then how luxurious do I want his tail to be? How big do I want it to be? Do I want to just use up the rest of this black fur? Why not? I'll have this big giant tail. What a pretty kitty tail. Let's see if that's all good. Not a torn part. Just hold it for a second. It turned out nicely. Here's our kitty so far. Oh my God. Nice kitty. She needs a little more though. You do need a little more, don't you? She needs to be embellished just a little bit. And I think that means a bell, because every kitty should have a bell so all the birds know where they're at. And I think you need a little pretty collar. So let me put the collar on. Let's measure. Okay, right about there. This is just some beaded string I had. Okay, baby, here you go. Cute little collar. I'm gonna just glue that, make sure it's all the way around. Goes under your fur a little bit. You should have a bell. Yes. Glue isn't coming out. You're in luck. You got one more second of freedom here. Here we go. Hold it for a second. Okay, we got your little collar. That is just befitting of a pretty little Himalayan. And the bell. How are we going to do that? You really need one. So I'm going to get a piece of elastic that I have here. And I'm going to attach that to your collar. And then we'll be done, kitty. Be done. Collar, elastic, bell. Okay, then I got that bell on there, and I'm going to slip off the extra excess. Just snip that off. So we've got your collar and we've got your bell. And of course, we'd have to do just a little bit of grooming just to make your fur look pretty. There's your ears. I don't know about the rest of you all, but I think this kitty is just short of adorable. Let's put you on and see what you look like. Okay, ready? This is the test. All right, aside from a big mess, there you go. I think you're all set. And there you have it, our new kitty. Her name is Amelia. Her name is Amelia. Oh my goodness, okay. Amelia is now part of our menagerie of puppets. If you like what you've seen here today, give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment. How many puppets have you made? I'm gonna keep making them, because I actually like you guys a lot. See you again.